morning to everyone. Mr. Subhayne Nandi, UNDP Resident Representative, Excellencies, Dr. Samal Kalegama, and Dr. Dilini Gunawadana, and other invited guests. It is my great pleasure to be associated with you this morning as a chief guest on the occasion of launching of the 2011 Human Development Report of the UNDP in Colombo, Sri Lanka. The 2011 Human Development Report of UNDP was launched globally on November 2nd, 2011 in Copenhagen, Denmark by the UNDP Administrator Helen Clark and Danish Prime Minister in Copenhagen. This year's report is titled Sustainability and Equity, A Better Future for All. And the report focuses on the challenges and sustainability and equitable progress and explores the intersections between environmental sustainability and equity. The report offers important new contributions to the global dialogue on this challenge, showing how sustainability is inextricably linked to the basic questions of equity, that is, of fairness, social justice, and of great access to better quality of life. The report emphasizes that promoting human development requires addressing sustainability locally, nationally, and globally, and this can and should be done in all ways that are equitable and empowering. Since this year's Human Development Report has given more emphasis on environmental issues. As the Minister of Environment of Sri Lanka, I would like to give some insights into some of the findings in the report. Climate change and its impacts has been identified as a key environmental issue. Climate change threatens to worsen disparities through the spread of tropical diseases such as malaria and dengue fever, and it also has an impact on crop yields, mainly decycling yields. Indoor air pollution is also a key issue, where it kills 11 times more people living in low HDI countries than people living elsewhere. Access to clean water, inadequate water and sanitation facilities, which have a greater impact on health and related issues, and intensity of health risks also have been identified as key issue in this report this year. The report ranks Sri Lanka at the 97th position out of 187 countries in the medium human development category for the quality of life of its citizens. Sri Lanka has jumped one place up from 2010. Sri Lanka is also ranked first in South Asia. Sri Lanka's human development index has increased up to from 0.691 in 2011 compared to 0.658 in 2010. The HDI of South Asia as a region increased from 0.356 in 1980 to 0.548 today, placing Sri Lanka above the regional average. India is ranked at 134th position, while Pakistan is at 145th and Nepal is at 157th. Maldives ranks 109th, and while Afghanistan is ranked the bottom of the region at 172nd place. Bangladesh is ranked 146th position. Overall, Norway, Australia, and Netherlands lead in the 2011 Human Development Index HDI, while the Democratic Republic of Congo, Niger, and Burundi are at the bottom of the Human Development Report's annual rankings of national achievement in health, education, and income, released yesterday by the UNDP. I think Sri Lanka has been able to achieve a higher ranking compared to other Asian countries due to a huge amount of investment. Sri Lanka is investing in education, health, livelihood development, and also other infrastructure development in water supply and sanitation. And the government is continuously investing in these areas, which will have a direct and positive impact on human development of the countrymen. And I must also emphasize that Sri Lanka believes in sustainable development. We have identified 10 trust areas, and we have formed a committee which is headed by His Excellency the President in development activities are formulated. And we are mindful that Sri Lanka as an island nation believes in development in sustainable manner, and we believe that we have to protect the environment in keeping with the line of the development that the people are thinking. And also we believe that Sri Lanka, the population, those who cannot get what they want because of their ability of not being able to get what they want, the government is stepping forward and we are giving lots of incentives to those people. And I think if you read the yesterday's budget, you will realize how much money we are investing on the rural sector, where we believe that rural sector development is key in development goals, that if we are going to achieve targets that we intend to have. And also I would like to tell you that Sri Lanka as a country is gone high up in every sphere. Now I can tell you I am from a village, though I am now living in a city. I know what a tremendous development it has taken place in the villages in the last 6-7 years, if you take 10 years. So we will keep on investing further for the development of the villages and also the development of infrastructure. And we know our health sector is developing very fast. We have built many hospitals, not only in Colombo, even in suburbs, and we can see superb healthcare system that is available for our people. And also we know we are a low carbon emitting country, and we want to continue that area, and we want to continue the same way that we are doing it, and we are mindful that whatever we do in development process, that we want to keep the environment intact. So I believe that this is a good eye-opener for every one of us, not only Sri Lanka, even other countries, that this kind of report will definitely pave the way for better development activities are to be taken place in the country. Further, I thank the UNDP for its development work carried out in Sri Lanka and in livelihood development, environment and sanitation, disaster management and other areas of human development initiatives carried out within the country. I thank UNDP again for this year's report. It's a wonderful report. I always prefer the report every year, and it launched today, and also the resident representative and the UN staff for organizing this event. Thank you.